One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours.
The AIDS Healthcare Foundation chose to use the soundtrack from the movie Selma for its 2018 Rose Parade float dedicated to the legacy of civil rights icon and Nobel Peace Prize winner, Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Aboard the 55-foot float, the image of Dr. King, members of the community who continue to work to keep alive the promise of Dr. King, the infamous Selma, Alabama, Edmund Pettus Bridge, and a reproduction of the Martin Luther King Jr. Memorial found in Washington, D.C.
Good evening. Dr. Martin Luther King, the apostle of nonviolence in the civil rights movement, has been shot to death in Memphis, Tennessee.
April 4th, 1968, Dr. King was shot to death at the age of 39. Confirmed racist and small-time criminal James Earl Ray confessed to the assassination.
We thought that it would be a fitting tribute both to honor Dr. King on the 50th anniversary of assassination, but also to continue carrying on the promise of justice and peace that he was striving for.
The story of the March 9, 1965 Edmund Pettus Bridge March and the Bloody Sunday Clash are among the many graphically told civil rights stories found here at the National Civil Rights Museum in Memphis, Tennessee.
So you look in front of us, we've got a version of the Edmund Pettus Bridge. And what we have before us is the actual footage of Bloody Sunday. Mm-hmm. And what you'll see is you will also see John Lewis being attacked. As a young man, him and Hosea Williams were at the front, and they were one of the people attacked.
Civil rights leader John Lewis, whose skull was fractured in the Bloody Sunday March for Voting Rights, became U.S. Congressman John Lewis, representing Georgia's 5th Congressional District. Hosea Williams, who was considered Dr. King's most trusted colleague, became a member of the Georgia State Assembly and continued his civil rights activities until his passing November 16, 2000.
Yes, there's some great leaders featured here in the gallery, but it really and truly is about the ordinary people doing extraordinary things in ordinary times. How are we going to be inspired by 1968? How are we going to be inspired by King's death to move forward? We have some really serious issues to address as a community. How are you going to do that? What are you going to do? What is your answer to the question, where do we go from here?
In Memphis, Tennessee, at the National Civil Rights Museum, Gayle Anderson, KTLA 5 News.